Here's a summary of the various 3JS settings for magnification, minification, and anisotropy. The minimal settings are listed first, the higher quality ones further down. Quality does cost more GPU processing time, so you have to decide what settings you can justify. The norm nowadays is to have linear magnification and the best quality mipmap filtering on. I should note that anisotropic sampling does not exist on older GPUs, though is an extension in WebGL. Each vendor has its own secret sauce as to how they implement this algorithm, so rendering quality can vary. The maximum anisotropic sampling rate can also vary from GPU to GPU. Calling the getMaxAnisotropy function gives the maximum rate possible on the GPU running the program. This is usually a power of 2, and usually no higher than 16. You can set the value higher if you want. 3JS will use the highest level available on the card. More samples cost more processing power, so again you need to decide what rate is reasonable. There are yet still better sampling methods possible, and anisotropic filtering is not the ultimate answer. I went into perhaps excessive detail on this aspect of the GPU, but for a good reason. This whole process of sampling and filtering comes up again and again throughout all of computer graphics. If you take too many samples, you're wasting time and possibly causing other problems. Too few and you can get artifacts. Where the samples are taken and how the samples are combined or filtered can also make a huge difference. Many processes can be thought of in these terms. Did I tessellate the surface enough to capture its essence? Should my computation happen in the vertex shader or the fragment shader? Should my shadow buffer have a higher resolution, or should I use a different algorithm? When I think of computer graphics and rendering as a whole, I think of it primarily in terms of sampling and filtering. Give the demo a try. It will show you the valid levels for your GPU. If you only see a value 1, it means your GPU does not support anisotropic filtering.